And welcome everyone to the first episode of the Duffy Dome. My name is Jarrod. I'm joined by my lovely lady, Julie. Say hello.
Hello.
We are here to talk to you about the Starz show Heels. And we're going to review every episode of the first season in anticipation of the second season.
Woo!
So why are we doing this?
Why are we doing this? I don't love wrestling.
I am a fan of Stephen Amell. I watched him in Arrow. I watched Heels. We are big fans of Knocking Point.
I do love his wine.
We are Knocking Point Quarterly Club members.
And coffee. And scented candles.
And shirts.
Thank you, Knocking Point.
So we have our quarterly delivery is coming.
Tuesday.
Oh, yeah.
Woo!
So we're excited about that. I'm a wrestling fan. I have been for as long as I can remember as a kid. And then for the last 23 years, I've been religiously watching wrestling. Stephen Amell being a participant in professional wrestling, he does a pretty damn good job of it.
He does.
And so,
surprisingly so.
I decided, you know, we can have, that's our hook. That's our gimmick is I'm a wrestling fan. You're not.
I'm not.
So we can watch this show together and look at it through the eyes of two different perspectives.
I think that's great.
So we're going to jump right into the first episode. Let me read you some credits here. Give credit where credit is due. We will be playing clips from the show, and I will warn you that there are spoilers. And if you have not watched the first episode of Heels, press pause. Head over to YouTube. First episode's on there for free.
And they're swearing. Spoiler alert, they're swearing.
Well, they're swearing. Yes, there's going to be swearing on this show too. Spoiler alert. This episode is called Kayfabe. It is written by the series creator Michael Waldron. It is directed by Peter Siegel. Cast is as credited. Stephen Amell as Jack Spade. Alexander Ludwig as Ace Spade. Allison Luff as Stacy Spade. Mary McCormick as Willie Day. Kelly Berglund as Crystal Tyler. Ellen Maldonado as Rooster Robbins. James Harrison Jr. as Apocalypse. Roxton Garcia as Thomas Spade, little kid. Chris Bauer as Wild Bill Hancock, along with Trey Tucker as Bobby Penn. Robbie Ramos as Diego Cottonmouth. And Duke Davis Roberts as Big Jim Kitchen.
That's a lot of people.
That's a lot of people, but it's a quality show.
None of them are professional wrestlers.
That's right. Stephen Amell has the most experience. There are professional wrestlers as we get into the show.
Okay.
As we get further.
Spoilers.
As we get further into the show, you'll see that. The basis for this show is that it is a small town wrestling promotion in Georgia that is trying to stay afloat. And there is competition across the border in Florida. So we have the Duffy Wrestling League, the DWL, run out of the Duffy Dome. And Jack Spade, played by Stephen Amell, is running the company. And his brother Ace, played by Alexander Ludwig, is one of the wrestlers. And they are on a crash course to meet in the ring.
They're a little cranky with each other, too.
They do. Through conversation, we learned that Ace and Jack's dad has died, and that Jack has taken over the family business.
Somewhat recently, it feels like.
It feels like it's
maybe
been
like a year or two.
Less than a year. Yeah. I can't remember if there's an actual timeline, but it gets into it. But you can tell that Ace is new to the business. Jack is running things, and the Jack versus Ace thing is building business back up. But Ace just doesn't seem to understand.
He's very self-involved. He doesn't get the big picture.
Yes. Let's go to our first clip.
Y'all want to see which Spade brother's really the king? Then you be back here next week. That's right. 1 week tonight, you and me in the main event.
Anytime, any place.
I just told you the time and place, stupid. You want this belt? You come and get it.
Hey, Jack.
Fuck you.
All right. So what we have right there is Jack continuing. Wrestling is episodic. You have to give the people a reason to keep coming back.
That's not something I knew before we got together. I just want to point out, like, I didn't realize wrestling had like a plot line and there was like episodes and things.
And I'm sure that it's not episodes in this situation because it's a small following, but Jack's trying to build it up with the internet and promoting it like that way. But he is getting people to come back.
Yes.
Ace, he says, fuck you, because Jack made him look dumb and people laughed at him.
Ace does not like people laughing at him. He's very self-involved.
Yes.
He's a big ego.
The theme of this episode is who should win the fight between Ace and Jack. And I asked you several times during the show.
You did.
Who should win? At this point, I said, who should win?
My answer was the same every time.
Who should win?
Jack.
Why?
Because otherwise, there's no anticipation. What are you gonna? How are you going to grow the business? How are you going to grow it? If Ace wins right away, then it's like, oh, okay. What's going to make people come back?
Correct.
Gold stars for me.
Gold stars for you. Ace just wants to be the champion. Ace just wants to win.
He doesn't see the big picture. He's spoiled.
On top of the drama of his brother leaving and the news of that, Jack Spade and the DWL are fighting off some competition.
They are.
Florida Wrestling Dystopia, Charlie Gully, played by Michael Malley.
I love Michael Malley.
I liked Michael Malley in Yes, Dear.
You know what? I think back to Michael Malley when he was on Nickelodeon. He was on, like, Guts, I think. It was like a kid's kind of adventure-y show, like, game show thing. Like, I remember Michael Malley from that, even.
Michael Malley is the showrunner for this, so we are getting an appearance by him, and he's also the boss.
Good for him.
Now, the clips that they're running of Florida Wrestling Dystopia are old school clips of TNA.
Oh.
It's from like 15 years ago.
How do they get that?
I don't know if they had a deal on that or if they got a little...
Ask nicely.
I guess ask nicely.
Pay money.
Now, as good as Jack is at learning the ropes of the wrestling business, he is not so good at communicating with his wife.
He's not. I was very annoyed with him. And justifiably, like, righteous anger for his wife. His poor wife.
There are a couple of times during this episode where he made purchases that his wife did not know about. And she told him such that she could track it. And I personally think that, because you can tell they're using their own funds to keep this thing afloat.
Yeah.
Smoke machines.
But he won't let her get a job.
Smoke machines and GoPros. And GoPros are expensive. I got one. And I told you when I bought it.
I know.
And Jack...
But we communicate. Do you see how you communicated with me about buying a GoPro?
Yes.
Versus him who bought a GoPro behind his wife's back. And he didn't even use his credit card to get points. When you bought a GoPro, there was like a rebate or something because you used your credit card points and things.
There was. Jack needs a business credit card.
Jack needs to separate his family finances and his business finances.
Let's go into Jack having a discussion with his lovely bride.
Think of it as time together as a family. I like that. Thomas does too. We heard our fight last night.
That wasn't fighting. That was loving with raised voices. And if our boy's gonna get hitched one day, he's gonna need to learn about things like raised voices and church guilt.
And four fog machines showing up out of nowhere. Expensive fog machines.
Expensive but durable. Wrestling's a show. It's theater. And we need a good fog machine.
Four fog machines.
Because the Dome's a big place. Mm-hmm. And my daddy bought shitty broken down fog machines. So I thought it'd be nice if I invested in our future.
Okay, well, yes. Well, if you told me our investment strategy included four fog machines, I would have been able to do a quick search on a half dozen websites that could have shipped these same four fog machines for substantially less dollars than you purchased them for.
You make a great point.
Hey, Jack, look. You know what's in this envelope?
Are we going together or are we driving separate?
Our coupons that I clip each week so we can stretch our dollars and just spend smart so we can just spend them on us. You know, like buying Thomas a new baseball bat or those Evo shields all his friends got. Or once a month seeing a movie in a theater instead of out of Redbox.
How do you feel about the accents, by the way?
You know what? I don't think they're too bad. Like, I mean, I'm not from Georgia. I'm from Texas. But, you know, it's not like glaringly obvious that the accents are fake, but it doesn't sound like a Georgia accent to me. But I think it's because it's more rural and not like, you know, you think of Georgia like
Georgia,
you know. So, but yes, they sound natural.
I like it when they say Duffy. And I just wanted to say we watched this episode twice.
We did. I missed a couple things the first time around.
The feel of the small town and the fact that Jack lives in the country, it resonated with me because I'm from the country and I went to school in a very, very small town, graduating class 30 people. So that was another part of the show that I identify with, because if there was that kind of thing in Duffy, or if there was that kind of thing that they have in Duffy in my area, I would have been there every week.
It reminded me of like my town. When I moved there, it was like Duffy. It was like very small. When I graduated high school, it was not as small, but it was like football. Like, I guess wrestling to them is what like football was.
Yeah. We were talking about how this is like Friday Night Lights for wrestling. Another thing that I identified with and I was like, whoa, that's accurate, is the church scenes.
Which I didn't know that was a thing, where you have like a potluck after church and you go and you socialize after church and all
oh,
that.
Oh, yeah.
We were Lutherans. We didn't do that.
Now, growing up in a Southern Baptist household like I did, that was your special occasions. It's not every week, but when you had the...
You guys bring your brownies and your cookies to church afterwards and...
Yeah.
Did you really? That's like a thing?
Yes. Everybody brings, you know, it's like a potluck at work, but it's better. Oh. And it's like, that's the thing, is you're sitting in church and you could smell the food and you're like, because we had, the church was upstairs.
Church guilt.
And then downstairs was where the Sunday school classes in the kitchen were. And you'd start smelling the food from downstairs. And you're like, man, I am hungry. The scene, there's a couple of things about the church scene. One, when Ace is pissing on the tree.
Oh, he's such a little... I want to slap him in the face, like, all the time.
And so, Big Jim's like, you're pissing on God's property. And then two, or Jack was there, but Jack did not want to be there.
He didn't socialize.
Where's Jack? In his Jeep. He didn't like being seen in public, much less being friendly the day of the match.
Especially not with yours truly.
That's... Kayfabe, right?
That's Kayfabe.
Gotta keep up the act all the time, even if it's outside of the ring, even if it's at church, so folks know it's real.
Protecting the business. Once when their father broke his leg during a match, he rolled around in a wheelchair for a month so the boys would think it really happened.
People know that it's fake, right?
Don't say fake. You're a wrestling wife now.
But yes, they know. But if they know, then what's the point?
How is it this man got you pregnant and he hasn't let you know this?
We were busy doing more important things, Mrs. Spade, like practicing getting pregnant.
Let's talk about intercourse, Mama.
Hush. Them believing one is good and one is bad makes them the audience part of the show.
Kind of ridiculous. Then again, every time he wrestles, it scares me to death. I don't know how you do it. Kayfabe.
Now we know what the episode story or the episode title means.
Now I know.
We're on the inside with some wrestling terms. Kayfabe.
Thank you, Stephen Amell, for explaining it to me.
We get introduced a little bit closer to some of the supporting cast when they find out the results, because Jack has been going back and forth on who should win the match. Even he doesn't know, even though we think Jack should win.
Mm-hmm. He doesn't decide till like the last minute.
Yeah. So we get to see more of Crystal and Rooster and Apocalypse.
Who I like. I like the supporting wrestlers.
Yes. Big Jim.
It's good to kind of see them explain more, and like you get to learn their personalities too. And it's really interesting to see how like everybody's a little unique.
And we get to see more from them as the show progresses. But this first episode is just Ace versus Jack and what to do. Ace finds out that he is losing in a 30-minute match, which you can look good in losing in professional wrestling.
How long are matches normally?
Normal TV match goes like 8 minutes.
Okay.
If 30
minutes seemed kind of long.
30 minutes is a back and forth. That way you look good. You fought the good fight, but you just fell short. Mm-hmm. And Crystal tries to explain this to Ace.
I like Crystal.
She has a mind for the business.
She does.
And if things were not complicated enough, let's bring in Wild Bill to recruit Ace to come up north.
Come up north.
Up north.
Air quote.
Air quote. We all know what up north.
They're talking about Vince, though. They said they mentioned Vince's name.
They mentioned Vince, but they can't mention WWE. But that's what the
insinuation
is that this is WWE. Now, while Bill has wrestled for DWL before, but he went up north and made his money, but now he's here to recruit Ace for developmental, which means basically he's going to go to the minor leagues and learn how to wrestle how they want him to wrestle.
He's not a very good influence.
Yeah. So let's hear the conversation between Jack and Wild Bill.
Listen, Bill, I get it. You made your choice. You did your thing. You went up north. You made yourself a career. Got the whole world championship belt above your head on national TV. But just because people know you here, just because your picture's on the fucking wall, don't mean you get to come back down here and patronize. Just because you got more, don't mean we got any less. This place, Jack, your dad built a cathedral to a local pastime. It's a community theater. It's a hobby. One of your own guys, your blood, leaving for the real thing, you should be proud of that. Because it's, honestly, best you can do. Bill, you get the fuck out of my office. You really are so much like him. What'd I say? My point exactly.
Now, knowing this, who should win the match?
I still think Jack should win the match. Because Ace is leaving. And Bill even says in the episode, spoiler alert, you know, it's not, they want to see Ace put on a good show. They want to see how he works the audience.
Tell a story.
Tell a story. It's not about if he wins or not, but Ace has such an ego, he's got to win.
Yes.
He gets cranky.
And in wrestling, when you are leaving, there's a phrase, you go out on your back.
Well, yeah, you're not going to leave as champion. Like, that's not, I mean, I agree. I understand. I don't even like wrestling, and I understand.
And Ace still is fighting this decision and trying to get a win. He's even suggesting endings to the match. Mm-hmm. But Big Jim says, it sounds like the end of something. That's the last match between Jack and Ace, not the first match between Jack and Ace. Mm-hmm. Ace doesn't get it. Ace wants the belt. Ace wants to have his cake and eat it too, and then get the hell out of town.
He wants everyone to love him.
So, of course, Wild Bill has a little conversation with Ace and
gives him some inappropriate contraband
and a little bad advice.
King Spade, Jack Spade, Ace Spade. Tom loved that stupid shit.
Jack used to drive me to school. That's one day my dad was loaded and...
Please don't fucking tell me a depressing story.
He just always trying to protect me, I guess. Thinks he still got it.
To keep you under his thumb. Keep you from getting what's yours.
Like the belt.
You need to send him a message. Baby brother's in charge now.
I could skip autographs.
Sure, that's one way. But back in our day, guy got out of line, Tom and I'd make sure a few punches landed for real. That's the shit I like to see. Jacob had the guts to wrestle with God. How about you?
Poor choices.
Poor choices. So now we have competition breathing down your neck. A brother ready to cut tail and run.
And people like Ace. Like people the fans like Ace. So that's they are hard.
Lined up for his meet and greet.
He doesn't even show up, that little punk.
And so Ace and Jack have a little discussion in the office and
discussion.
Well, they're
a heated discussion. It was yelling with raised voices.
Well, that it's just it's building to the match. Finally, Ace goes out to his meet and greet, meets all the fans, his adoring fans, and then we get the wrestling montage. The show is starting. It's a packed house. We get our first wrestling, actual wrestler appearance. The big LG, Doc Gallows, is in the Battle Royal. We get a look at some of the other characters having their perspective or respective wrestling matches. And that leads to Jack versus Ace. But right before they go to the ring, there's a little bit of a discussion.
Are you taking me with you when you leave Duffy?
No.
Nope. He's not.
Fuck the belt. Already won. I go wrestle a match of my life, and it's like you said. I get to leave, and you stay here. Forever. Till you end up killing yourself like Dad.
Right before the match starts. So they're supposed to go 30 minutes. But seeing this from Jack's perspective.
That was not 30 minutes.
Yes. You got a brother who's leaving. He's already pissed you off. I think he says that. Jack has to do what he has to do to protect the business. And when the match starts, sneaks up on Ace, hits a back suplex, a German suplex, and then puts him in an arm bar and tells the ref, you're going to have to call this or I'm going to break his arm.
Yep.
Screw job. Not what the people paid for.
They were dissatisfied.
And I pointed this out during the montage. When Diego Cottonmouth is in the ring, they're booing him and they're throwing trash at him. That doesn't happen.
It doesn't?
It doesn't.
That's not a thing.
And it took a little bit away from them throwing trash at Ace and Jack.
Mm-hmm.
Because if they'd shown the disgust, that was my one little nitpick of this episode, was they shouldn't have been showing the trash being thrown at other people. That should have been saved.
For Ace
and Jack.
For that moment of very much frustration.
The air just left the room. Ace slugs Jack. People start booing and throwing trash. The screw job is in. Jack did what he had to do to take care of the business. And Ace cries.
He cries. Nothing wrong with having emotions.
I don't know.
He cries, though.
So Jack did what he needed to do. But at what cost? He's cost his brother a spot, obviously.
And now it's like if you keep him, people are mad about the two of you. It's like when we... Several of those matches we'd watch, you know, in UFC when Ronda Rousey was really big and she was winning all her matches, you know, and there was one and they hyped it and they hyped it and they hyped it. And it ended in what, like 12 seconds or something outrageous. And yeah. I feel like I just sat down to watch it and I was like, well, this is very anticlimactic. And it's like, that's very impressive, but this isn't what I paid for. So now I'm kind of bummed.
Paid for.
You know what I mean? But these people, like, I can see exactly, I mean, these fictional people, like, why they're mad. Because it's like you pay to go to this wrestling show and you're expecting a 30-minute match and it's like, boom, broke his arm, here you go, he's crying.
Well,
match is over.
Just stretched his arm a little.
Stretched his arm, made it look a little broken, and now he's sad and the match is over. Like, okay, where do we go from here?
Where do we go from here? We go to the next episode. How did you feel about Kayfabe in its entirety?
I feel like it was a good first episode. Like, it established all the characters really well. It explained some background information about wrestling, which I didn't know and was helpful to people like me who are not, like, wrestling aficionados.
Me.
But I also, it did not endear Jack or Ace to me. I was not, I feel like they both have a huge ego. They both have some very, like, big flaws, which I hope the series will show us they grow a little. They definitely have room to grow as human beings.
So I've seen this series and you have not, which is funny.
Yes.
Because I know how this ends. I know how this season ends.
You have not told me either. Like, I have not been spoiled.
And we will find out very quickly how the story progresses, but... It's enough of a good episode for you to want to come back for more, correct?
Yeah. No, I'm intrigued. I'd like to see the next one.
Good. Because that's what's going to happen next time when we are back with episode 2.
Hooray.
You can find us on Twitter at The Duffy Dome. And you can find this podcast wherever you find all your fine podcasts. Tell us what you like about the show. Tell us what you didn't like. Leave us some comments on social media. Give us a rating on Spotify or Apple Podcasts.
But don't throw trash at us.
But don't throw trash at us. Save that for the main event, for the heels. And if you want to see more from us, if you want to see us unbox our Knocking Point box.
Oh, we should unbox our Knocking Point order when we get it.
Because I am excited. I'm always excited to see what the, since they did stop doing shirts, I'm like, what's it going to be?
What's our special gift going to be?
Yeah.
And we haven't ordered extra wine recently, so I'm out of wine. So.
Uh-oh.
We need more.
Well, it's on the way a couple of days from now. So, I am Jarrod.
I'm Julie.
And this has been The Duffy Dome. We thank you for listening. Come back and see us. Have a good one.
Bye.